post-race, post-podium, where we have Catharine Pendrel. How'd it go today? And tell us a little about what happened out there. There's some major gaps going on.
It was hot. Georgia and I got away pretty early together. We just seemed to have a little bit more pace and could roll off the front. And then about a little over halfway through, she attacked on a steep little pitch and just started opening a gap. And she just held it to the finish, and I chased her down, and girls were chasing behind me. So, yeah, it was suffering out there.
It was.
Yeah.
What was at the feed zone? Was there a gap at that point? Or
between Georgia and I?
Mm-hmm.
No, we were together at that point, yeah. And then probably about 5 or so minutes later, she attacked, yeah.
So when you finally finish here, about a minute plus on you,
yep.
On what I call Heartbreak Hill.
Okay.
The last large climb with no trees. How much did you gap after that point?
I haven't a clue.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Came back,
yeah. Oh, was it closer at the end?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay, yeah. Yeah. Not sure, yeah.
Closer.
I think at one point it had grown to 2, and then kind of I got my legs back. You know, when it's hot and you get by yourself, I definitely lost focus for a while.
Mm-hmm.
But then was able to kind of regroup a little bit because I knew if I lost too much focus then I'd have people catching me from behind and that would have been sad.
So what was today? You've done this particular circuit before, haven't you?
Yeah, you know, it's a little different than the past, but I've definitely raced a long course before. This is the first time that we've only done one lap of the long course. So they made the long course a little bit longer, but so it was about an hour and a half of racing, I think.
Compared to what you've raced here before, do you prefer this type of track?
You know, honestly, I the riding is really good, but I prefer shorter laps. I just find it easier to gauge your effort and to keep your focus when you kind of hit the same sections over again. And I kind of like the idea of being able to build on what you've done before and choosing better lines, being smoother, being faster. So yeah, I like the World Cup format, but I think it's good to switch it up like this too.
Mm-hmm. Does this help build any of your training for London?
Yeah, you know, because of the nature of this course, it's so just like constant, more of a diesel course than a World Cup, like on off on off. So I think it is good. I mean anytime you race, it's the best form of training. But definitely I'm looking forward to going home and just having a couple weeks to train and rebuild and not be changing time zones and being on planes and stuff like that.
Your field competition day, how would you gauge it compared to what you're going to face in London?
Today versus London, you know, definitely there was really strong competition here. There's about 7 girls that have all been top 10 at World Cups before, so definitely a strong field. You know, totally different course than you'll see in London, so it's kind of hard to compare that way. Yeah, you know, I think World Cups are definitely the best comparison. However, at the Olympics, we're only going to have 25 or 30 girls rather than, you know, 60 to 110 that you get out of World Cup. So that does definitely change the dynamic a bit. But yeah, no, this is, you know, a strong field and just like every World Cup. So.
Yeah. Off the cuff question. If you were any kind of fruit, what would you be?
You know, orange came to mind right away, but I'm not sure why. Maybe it's because I feel really hot and that would be cold and refreshing and juicy. But I don't think that, I wouldn't describe myself as juicy. you've got me on that one.
Great. Any last, let's see, you're going to be going back home in London. Between now and London, what do you see, what are you going to tweak between now and then as far as
Well, I don't want to give away my secrets, but yeah, you know, I have to be better on every aspect. You know, I think in London, I'm going to have to be able to put down a decisive move at some point. So improving my ability to, if I make a move, make it a good one. So, yeah.
Any special, I guess you're going to tell me what kind of food or regimen. Obviously you're with Luna, so I know they have a lot of great power bars and juices and all that. Anything at your 31 years of age that you think helped you a lot being at such a great state of fitness?
Yeah, you know, like I definitely subscribe to the if it's not broke, don't fix it. I don't do a lot of funny stuff with my dieting or my training or things like that. I use what's worked for me in the past and just have faith in my program, my coaching and everything. So yeah, just eat healthy. You know, it's kind of the 90-10 rule, you know, 90% good for you and then you can have your treats too. And yeah, just, you know, it's Olympic year, but that doesn't mean you have to do anything crazy, right? If you keep doing what has been working for you, that's going to be your best strategy going into the Olympics. And, you know, trying to do something, a drastic change to get an amazing result, amazing difference, is probably more likely to backfire on you than to get you ahead.
After you celebrate London, for whatever happens, how do you celebrate? Do you have a big meal with all of your friends and family, or?
Yeah, we've got the, I'll be sticking around for the men's race, which will be the next day. We race the second last day of the Olympics, which kind of means you don't really get to experience a ton of the Olympics because you're pretty focused beforehand. But yeah, definitely, you know, I'll be making time to go for dinner with all my friends and family. And I've got a lot of British relatives. I've got a lot of family that's planning to be there. So I just hope that if anybody knows me and is in London, that like we can find a communal meeting place and get together and have fun.
Thanks so much.
Thanks.
All the luck. Best luck over there.
Thank you.